You've tried everything, your router's Wi-Fi zone is not covering your house fully. There are still rooms with poor Wi-Fi signal. Consider adding more access points. If you already have a MikroTik AX device and if you want to increase your Wi-Fi range by adding another MikroTik AX device, check out this video. It is going to be about a first time basic CAPsMAN installation. But first, what is a CAPsMAN? CAPsMAN is a feature that allows you to transform any MikroTik device into an access point manager. When managed, APs are called CAPs. Why separately configure each AP, especially if you have multiple, when you can simply connect all of them to the CAPsMAN device and configure all of them through the CAPsMAN? In our example, let's assume you have HAP-AX3 as the main Wi-Fi router, and you have HAP-AX2 that you want to use as an additional AP for better coverage. In this scenario, we'll make AX3 a CAPsMAN and AX2 a CAP. The CAP needs to be connected to the CAPsMAN's network via an Ethernet cable, so make sure that an Ethernet cable is passed down along the way. Let's start with the router. To check how to connect to the router settings, see our previous video. Step number 1. Connect to the device that is about to become a CAPsMAN and navigate to the Wi-Fi Remote CAP tab. Click on the CAPsMAN settings and enable the functionality. Step number 2. Create a preset profile with Wi-Fi settings that you want to apply to all your managed Wi-Fi devices. Under the Wi-Fi Configuration tab, add a new profile. Name your wireless network in the SSID field. Select your country. In the Security tab, under the Authentication Type section, checkbox VPA2 PSK and VPA3 PSK options. And lastly, specify your Wi-Fi password in the passphrase field. Step number 3. Configure provisioning rule in the Wi-Fi provisioning tab. Those rules specify which devices should receive the configuration from the previous step. Add the rule, then specify action, create dynamic enabled, and select master configuration to be a preset profile we've just made. If you require to separate 2.4 and 5 GHz network names, just create a second Wi-Fi config preset with a different SSID name for the other band. Then create two separate provisioning rules for each config preset, but specify supported band setting, where you can set the band to which the preset should be applied to. Step number 4. In the Wi-Fi tab, apply the same preset profile to your current Wi-Fi interfaces. And now get the CAP ready. Please remember that in factory settings, most of our devices are configured as routers. So if you power on, for example, HAP-AX2 from the get-go, it will act as a router. But do not worry, you can put your MikroTik Wi-Fi device into the CAPs mode very easily using two options. Option A, you can use the reset button to let the mode. Press the reset button and hold it pressed. Then apply power and wait for about 10 seconds. After the first 5 seconds, the LED will start blinking. And after 5 more seconds, the LED will switch to a solid color. This is when you release the button. Option B. You can use graphical interface to do the exact same thing. Connect to settings, navigate to the System Reset Configuration tab, check box CAPs mode, click on Reset Configuration, and confirm your choice. You followed either option, your AP rebooted and loaded into the CAP mode. Connect this CAP with an Ethernet cable to the router's network and enter CAPsMAN settings again. The last step is to go to the Wi-Fi tab and verify that new CAP Wi-Fi interfaces appeared for management. You can also confirm that an AP is managed under the Remote CAP tab. That's it. You have 4 Wi-Fi interfaces to manage instead of 2, which means you have successfully installed an additional AP. And both devices should now broadcast the same Wi-Fi name because they use the same preset. For more detailed info on the CAPsMAN options, please see our other CAPsMAN video by Toms. Thank you for watching and stay tuned.